one of the racing drivers, Bill Gates, who was a local DJ on Radio 4BH in Brisbane, came to visit us the next day and asked if he could promote us. In those days, they didn't use the term management. Could I be your promoter? You know, and we thought, whatever that is, yeah, sure. You know, I'll be your promoter and I'll get you on the air and we'll do some recordings. Wow, I thought, you know, this is amazing. And he had another gentleman with him called Bill Good. They were both racing drivers. Both of them had the initials BG. And that, along with our mother's initials being BG, my initials being BG, brother's GIBB being BG, he came up with the suggestion that we call ourselves the BGs. But in those days, it was just BGS. And so we had he presented us with a guitar with the letters BGS on the bottom. And that's how the name was born. But later we changed it.
You know, needed a name. And of course, one of the fashionable names of the times was names like the Rattlesnakes, which is the name we first went with. So we became the Rattlesnakes for a few weeks, maybe a couple of months. And then we changed it to Wee Johnny Hayes and the Blue Cats. Because there was a TV show. There was a TV show on television at the time called 6-5 Special, which was full of people with names like this. And we thought, well, you know, in those days, you've got to be like everyone else. So we called ourselves Wee Johnny Hayes and the Blue Cats. I don't know what it was after that, but the Bee Gees didn't come into existence until we got to Australia with the meeting of Bill Gates and Bill Good, who actually came up with the name Bee Gees for us, which was a play on his initials, Barry's, Brothers Gibb, Bill Good, and it's been that ever since. Started off as BG apostrophe S, and then BWG.
Well, what happened is we always looked for some really cool name. And I remember the first, because skiffle was the big music that was in at the time in England. And there's a man called Lonnie Donegan and Johnny Duncan, I should say, who had these hits of sort of skiffle, like washboard, you know, banjo guitars and very exciting music. And it was sort of blues but country at the same time. And it was great stuff. And that was the big music of the time. So Rattlesnakes, very skiffle. And I played the tea chest, which is this chest with the aluminum corners, and you'd have the broom handle and the piece of rope, and I was playing bass. So that's how we used to stand on the street corner in Chawcombe Hardy playing. I used to have the tea chest thing, and I'd be playing the bass. And that was a very skiffle thing, to play sort of instruments that you made from home stuff, you know. So that was very popular. So Rattlesnakes was a very cool word. And then we heard of a guy called Wee Willie Harris, who is... This man was big red hair stuck out, and he wore this Tarzan type leopard skin thing, no trousers, just, you know, short, and played the piano like Little Richard, but was as white as anything, but very white actually, and very freckly. So he was a big pop star. He had this big hit, and we sort of thought, well, Wee Johnny Hayes and the Blue Cats sounds really cool, because we asked Mum to get us 3 pairs of blue jeans. And they weren't like Levi's, like jeans that they had. They were very badly, cheaply made, bright blue trousers. So we thought they were jeans, and the three of us had them on. And we're, right, it's Wee Johnny Hayes and the Blue Cats. And we thought, well, who's Wee Johnny Hayes? And we went, we don't know. Nobody was really Wee Johnny Hayes, but we just thought it was such a cool name. So we had that for a while. Then with the Bill Good, Bill Gates connection, after Bill had done his thing on the radio, they came back to the house, and we were sitting and just talking around, thinking about a name. And of course, there was Brothers Gibb. And there was, of course, Bill, and Bill Gates had noticed there was Bill Good, Barry, Barbara, our mum, Brothers Gibb, their initials. He said, there's so many BGs in the room. He said, why don't you just be called the BGs? Which was B.G apostrophe S then. So we thought, oh, okay. So, which really, as he said, stood for Brothers Gibb. But there's so many BG initials in the room, you know, that's what you're going to be called. In fact, when we got to England, if the first record didn't go, we were going to change the name, because we'd been the Bee Gees for like 11 years. You know, so we thought maybe if we change our name, it'll be hipper in England, you know? So Spicks and Specks was released, and it did really well. The New York Miami Disaster was a deciding record. If that didn't make it, we were going to change our name. And we had names like Rupert's World, the Monmouths, I think, was another one. God, they were so funny. Of all the names that we could be, but New York Mining Disaster, strangely enough, was a hit. So it was a minor hit, but it got us established in England, and we thought it was too late then. So.